Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So tonight's video is going to be just a follow-up to yesterday's video. After today, I'm not bringing this up again. I'm not in live streams on here on YouTube. I'm just not. Peter has apologized and owned up to everything. And while I cannot accept the apologies given for all the tweets, because, I can't accept all of them, it's not my place to accept all of them, I can say that I do accept the apologies for the tweets that I was personally offended by or upset with. You may have noticed that I privated my video from yesterday for a good portion of the day yesterday, and that was because I was made aware of the rest of the tweets. I was under the impression that I received all the tweets in my DMs because many of the DMs I had gotten at the time were all repeats of the same tweets. Not to mention, I had watched another video that had the same tweets in it, so I just assumed that's all there were as far as the tweets. I did not purposefully leave out anything, guys, and I apologize if that was the impression you had gotten from my action, or at least in this case, I guess a lack thereof in regards to these tweets. And the same people who told me about the tweets also provided me with a link to a website called Guru Gossip. Now, I want to get this out of the way right now. I've mentioned Guru Gossip on Twitter as of yesterday, I think it was, but I want to talk about this in this video right now. I've received a lot of DMs from people, as well as text messages, just telling me about how I myself, along with a couple other fellow drama channels here in this platform, are being verbally torn apart on the forums pertaining to this Peter Mon situation. And quite frankly, that's fine. It is what it is. I expect this kind of behavior and this kind of thing to come from that website. If you've been a subscriber of mine for any length of time, you may or may not remember a video I put up. I want to say it was like a year and a half ago, in which I specifically talk about the reasons why I don't like that forum. And all the reasons I list in that video are still valid today. I stand by everything I said in that video. But before I go any further, I want to clarify that not every single user on that platform is dedicated to trashing people. There is a section called the Rave About a Guru section that is far more positive as far as conversation. But the majority of the traffic on that website revolves around the Trash a Guru section. That section in particular is what this website is known for. So naturally, I was kind of annoyed that the only links being given were ones to Guru Gossip. I myself have chosen to avoid that place like the plague, and for good reason, but they seem to be the only place that had all of the screenshots for the tweets and everything, so for that, I do give them credit. I will admit that when I first saw the tweets I had missed, I was very disappointed, and I even took to Twitter and mentioned my disappointment. Unfortunately, while grabbing the tweets from the Guru Gossip thread, because you had to scroll around to find some of them, you inevitably saw some of the disgusting comments being left by these people. They were attacks on Peter Mon's family, his relationship with his husband. I mean, these people know no bounds when it comes to the attacks, and it's sad. And honestly, guys, I mean, I don't want to tell you guys to go to the website and waste your time because it's just, you'll leave that website feeling so much more shittier about yourself than you did probably going into it. But they've had it out for this dude for quite a while, and it can be proven if you were to take a few minutes of your time and just go look at the many threads created about him. They go back quite a while, and it sucks. But anyways, that's besides the point. Regardless, seeing these tweets really did upset me. I was, like I said, very disappointed. I went to Twitter and talked about it on Twitter. As a matter of fact, a lot of you guys had your own conversations on that tweet with me and with other people as well. And it hurt because I've mentioned it before, I look up to Peter, and I've always appreciated his perspectives on everything, especially when it came to his addiction videos. I have a close family member who is an alcoholic, a struggling alcoholic as it stands today, unfortunately. And I find that I get a lot of really good advice watching his addiction videos. And that's what initially really drew me to his channel was those videos, because I felt like I was getting help from someone without having to actually go and, see someone like a counselor or whatever to get help from them. And it just, I don't know, I felt it feels genuine from him. So to see things like these tweets posted by him come up, I felt very upset and, like I said, disappointed. And so it was shocking to see those kind of tweets come from someone that I looked up to so for so long. In any case, I do want to point out that I stand by what I said in my part one on this subject. In some of these tweets that have been exposed, context absolutely matters. As a matter of fact, in part one, I pointed out that some of the things that were being shown as him actually typing out the N-word, there was one where he did, but the other two were just reposts, and yet people like the individual whom I found those screenshots through, they were making it out as Peter continuously saying that same word every single time when that's just not the case. People were calling Peter a racist because of the monkey tweet, but I'm sorry, I personally did not see it that way at all. If you yourself personally associate the word monkey with people of color, that sounds like a you problem because I would never in my life automatically hear the word monkey and think of a person of color. Speaking of Peter, he and I did have a conversation. He reached out to me personally and asked to talk on the phone with me about the tweets. And the entire conversation was, it was a very good conversation. I enjoyed talking to him, and we sat and went through each of the tweets. Not once did he ever make an excuse or try to justify the tweets that were flat out disrespectful. He said, "There's no excuse for it. I don't know why I did it, but I apologize." At the end of everything, he personally to me apologized to me personally for any of the tweets that I may have found offensive, and I accepted that apology, and that was that. All in all, the person you see every day across four different channels is the exact same person you get behind the scenes. That's my honest opinion, and I'm sure there are a lot of people who can vouch for me. I have had very good experiences and conversations with Peter. I don't get any bad vibes, any weird vibes, any fake vibes. Who you see online is who you get behind the scenes, and that is a fact. I've had a lot of people ask me on Twitter, Snapchat as well, how do you feel about this? What's your honest opinion on his apology videos? And that is why I sat down to make this video today. It's my reaction to the apology video. I'm in no way, shape, or form making excuses for him. I'm not co-signing anything, and he knows that because I was very honest with him yesterday and very blunt about everything. And but ultimately what I'm not gonna do is go in or bash anybody who has apologized and genuinely owned up to their fuck ups. I am someone who is so thankful that I had people in my own life who were able to look past what I had done and accept my apologies for those things. And they allowed me to stay in their lives to show them that I meant what I said when I told them that I would do better. If by some chance I slipped up in my attempts to be a better person, they would clock my ass with quickness, okay? And it's those people that I appreciate more than anything in the world because it's those people that held my ass accountable for my own actions. What kind of person would I be if I kept going in on Peter for this situation, or Gabriel Zamora for what he started, and all that bullshit, or even perhaps Jeffree Star for the things they've already apologized for? And you know what? While we're at it, people want to keep bringing up Laura Lee's situation in comparison to Peter's as far as the apology. There is no comparison whatsoever. There's no good comparison in this whatsoever. Laura has yet to apologize genuinely for anything. She hasn't owned up to anything either. She did, however, try to pass the tweets off as retweets instead of owning up to them actually being her tweets, her thoughts at that point in time. As a matter of fact, wasn't she the one liking tweets, telling people to get over old tweets? I mean, she's shown that she doesn't care. At to this point, that's the vibe I get from her. I wish no ill will towards this woman whatsoever. That's not my intention. And hopefully the break she's taking does her some good. But she did not apologize or take ownership of anything, and her tweets are absolutely malicious in nature. There's no denying it. Based off of what I saw between Peter's first video and his second one especially, and from what he has said to me personally, Peter has owned up to everything and he's made no excuses. I do not believe whatsoever that he is the person he was back when those tweets were first posted. That's just my opinion, and you're more than welcome to form your own based off of what you have seen, but I myself do not believe that he is the same person he was back then. He is definitely a changed person, and just from watching his videos over the past few years, you can tell that he is in a completely different mindset, a more positive, wiser mindset than what he was back then. I have said this so many times in the past few weeks, I feel, so much so that it's pretty much like embedded in my head now. But I've said so many times, it's up to each of us, I should say, to decide whether or not someone is worth your continued support when it comes to things like this. It is your choice to support whomever you'd like, free of judgment. That is up to you completely. As for me personally, I believe Peter is a good person. I believe that he has grown and matured in the time between those tweets and now. So to everybody on Guru Gossip, in the comment sections or whatever the case may be, wherever things like this are said, a lot of people are reading me to filth because I'm not dragging or going in on Peter for what has been done. But why would I do that when he's already apologized? He's owned up to everything. Like I said, it's up to each of you to decide for yourselves whether or not you can accept or not accept his apology. And if you don't accept it, that is perfectly fine. You know, hopefully there are millions of creators here on YouTube across so many different channels and genres. Hopefully you can find someone else to enjoy and watch and move on from it and be done with it. But what I'm not going to do is sacrifice or go against my morals and drag someone for the next 100 years for something that, in my opinion, they genuinely apologized for. Especially not when it was that same act of forgiveness that was granted to me that I depended on to be able to move on and be a better person. And who would I be if I didn't give that same act of forgiveness to somebody else? You know what I mean? So that's all I have to say for you guys for today. Thank you guys so much for watching. Leave your opinions down below, as always, and I will see you guys in the next video. I love you guys so, so much. Bye.